Space sciences. Sending your experiment into space. That is challenging. It's exciting, it's fun, and it brings us a lot of new knowledge. But it's not feasible for schools, right? Or maybe it is. Meet the ASGARD project. Each year, student teams send their own experiments into near space. What is near space?
Almost everything that we associate with the air above us happens in the lowest 10 kilometers above the Earth's surface. This 10 kilometers layer is called the troposphere. It's where the weather forms and the aircraft fly.
Above it is the stratosphere, which can best be explored with weather balloons. This is not space yet, but from 30 kilometers height, the sky is black. You're above most of the ozone layer, and you can see the curvature of Earth's horizon, as in this picture, made by students from Atheneum Willebroek.
At this altitude, the conditions are very similar to those on the planet Mars. High levels of UV radiation, temperatures far below 0 degrees, extremely dry air, and pressures that are less than 1% of those at sea level on Earth. Our students are challenged to design an experiment that can operate in these tough Mars-like conditions.
To reach near space, we use a large stratospheric balloon from my institute, the Royal Meteorological Institute in Brussels. The balloon is filled with hydrogen, the lightest of all gases. When the balloon rises, outside pressure drops and the balloon will expand. Finally, it becomes so big that it will explode. The gondola with the payload falls back to Earth, but of course we slow it down with a parachute.
Participating in ASGARD is like going through a complete space mission. Your team has to submit a written proposal before November 11th. And then a jury selects about 12 experiments that will fly. The teams are informed about this selection before Christmas. Then comes the biggest challenge: designing, building, and also testing your experiment until it works, even in near space conditions. Finally, you deliver your experiment to the program organizers.
For the flight campaign, all the teams come together at the scientific institutes of the Spacepole in Brussels for a 3-day program and the launch of the ASGARD balloon. The first day, all teams give presentations to each other about their experiments, and all the experiments are integrated in the gondola and prepared for takeoff.
The long-awaited balloon flight takes place on the second day. For this exciting event, all the teams gather at the launch site. While an adventurous team of organizers and students sets out to recover the gondola, the other students are offered an exciting mix of workshops, presentations, and guided tours by my colleagues, professional Earth and space scientists.
The third and final day, the teams offer a first look at their results. Before the end of the school year, each team produces a scientific poster, which will then be published on the ASGARD website. Of course, given the challenging conditions in near space, an experiment might fail. But even so, valuable lessons can be learned. For example, on project management, component selection, or testing procedures.
ASGARD experiments cover many disciplines. There are always teams that have cameras aboard, or that measure basic parameters like air pressure or temperatures. Some teams go farther. They measure radiation, or test the speed of sound in the stratosphere. Or they even try to find signs of life at high altitudes. Some experiments, on the other hand, are more passive, like the biological ones, sending enzymes or eggs or living cells into near space, and then they compare them with a control group on the ground.
But all experiments are subjected to the following conditions. No live animals are allowed on board. Each experiment must weigh less than 150 grams. Power consumption must be limited. And of course, no flammable or radioactive materials are allowed on board. Let's have a look at some examples that flew with ASGARD in 2016.
Blood in space.
Onderzoeken wat het effect van de ballonvaart is op bloedcellen. Steken vier buisjes gevuld met varkensbloed.
We hebben vier buisjes zodanig dat we een backup hebben voor meer resultaten. Twee van de buisjes zijn ook doorprikt zodanig dat we het effect van de luchtdruk kunnen gaan meten.
Wat denk je dat er gaat gebeuren?
En we verwachten dat de bloedcellen gaan kapot springen door de lage temperatuur en de lage druk.
We're walking on your V-rays.
We onderzoeken hoe de hoogte de hoeveelheid UV-straling beïnvloedt.
We gebruiken een sensor waarmee we de UV-straling meten en die data schermen met SD-kaart.
Energy in space.
Misurare l'energia solare attraverso una cella fotovoltaica.
I raggi solari arrivano sulla cella fotovoltaica che li converte in energia elettrica che aiuterà le batterie sulle convolute.